Okay, everybody, this is Jeff again, and we're going to be talking about using EBSCO today to do some basic searching. So let's say that you're in a class and they want to see how certain activities would improve or hamper academic performance. So I'm going to say, just hypothetically, let's say we're going to go with alcohol. Okay, how would alcohol, what kind of articles can we find out there that show what effects alcohol would have on your academic performance or your school? So I'm going to go with alcohol here, and I'm going to do my little trick you've probably seen me do before, a shift 8, which is asterisk, and that's going to bring up alcohol or alcoholism or any other, or alcoholic, any other version of alcohol we could find out there. Now also, I'm going to use or here because it might be under there under drinking or something like that. And it also could be or beer or whatever, but I'm just going to go with alcohol or drinking. And let's do a search here, see how many results we get back. And as you notice, I'm kind of doing this one step at a time, one box at a time. I'm not going to search for all the terms. I'm not going to search for alcohol, school performance, or anything. I'm not going to do all that at once. I don't like to do that. The more terms you type in there, that's going to start eliminating things. So we're going to start with this. Okay, we got a lot of stuff. 74,046 results. Way too many, obviously, but we're gonna see about narrowing this down. Now, this is just the way that I would do it. You might have your own ways of doing it. I'm just giving you a hypothetical example of how I might do this. So here, the selective field thing, if I click this arrow, it's kind of searching generally now. What if I change this to title? So I want alcohol or drinking in the title of all the articles. And again, I'm taking it really slowly, one step at a time. No need to get in a hurry here. Got all the time in the world. Okay, now we're down to 17,560. Notice I'm not even looking through the articles right now. Lindsay Lohan drinking again. There's so many articles here and it's really unfocused, but I'm gonna focus in as we go. I'm not gonna stop here. I'm not even gonna look because I know with that many articles, it's just bringing up everything now. Now I'm gonna start trying to make this a little bit more specific. So how about I put in here and in the next box, school or test. Maybe we could put an asterisk there for test or testing, or academic. Let's go with that for now. So I'm gonna have this or that with that or that or that. Okay, let's do a search and see what we get now. So it's doing its thing here. I see the little blue bar. Okay, and we're steadily decreasing, you can see, in the number of articles, 4,540. Okay, so we've still got a ton of stuff here. Let me, as I'm taking a look here, I'm gonna start to take a look here and see what I'm gonna find. Okay, now you know, since I had drinking in there, we're gonna find all kinds of drinking. Now that's kind of the problem of using or. So there is sometimes a downside to using ors. So as I'm going here, like I said, we're just doing this trial and error. Let me take out drinking from there and we'll just do alcohol. Let me rerun the test. Like I said, we've got enough. We have all the time in the world here. So going here, and did it do, is it still working on it? I see the little, okay, 3,688. Changed a little bit, took out some of those articles. And looking good here. Now we can also use not. How about let's eliminate some things here. I'm going to change this little arrow here to not. What are some words I don't want to see in here? Okay, there. I'm really not too interested in post-traumatic or PTSD. So not post-traumatic or PTSD. Let me see if there's any other things I'd like to eliminate from my search here. Because now a big part of this is eliminating things here too. Okay, let's see. I'm not really interested in fetal alcohol syndrome, so I can do that. So I'm going to put not fetal. Let's see here. Let's see. A lot of this looks pretty good. I'm going to take, so let's say, I'm not sure how many you'll take out, but I also don't want to, remember we have the not here. So when I put post-traumatic, I don't want to see this. I don't want to see that. And I don't want this in the articles. And like I said, I've got all the time in the world. Just gonna take my time here and slowly weed these down to the types of articles I want to see. Took a few off. Okay, now here I think we still have so many to work with here. Let's take this to title. The second box, school or test or academic, has to be in the title. And I just slowly, one step at a time, try to make this more and more specific. Now we're down to 314. Now we're starting to talk. Okay. Now we're getting into a manageable level of articles. And remember, when I did my first search, I had over 70, what did I have? 75,000 articles. So I'm starting to look pretty good here. And there's probably, if I started looking through all these, I'd probably find some good articles, but let's say I want to cut to the chase. Let me take this out now. What if, how many of these would have the phrase academic performance in the title? Now notice I'm putting a quotation marks around this. I want this exact phrase. That's why I'm putting it in quotation marks. I want this exact phrase in the title. I want alcohol in the title, some version of alcohol with the asterisk. I want that exact phrase, academic performance, and I don't want to see any of these terms in there. Let's see what happens there. Now you're thinking I probably could have reached this conclusion earlier, but this is how I do searches. I do them trial and error, and I figure out the strategy as I go. See here, we've hit the search. Okay, it's okay, we're down to one article, but look at this. Understanding college alcohol abuse and academic performance. Okay, this would be a great article. This would be, and there's probably others out there that are going to be good, and I could go back and do some other searches, but I narrowed it down from 75,000, or however many that huge number was, down to one, and this article is talking about exactly what I'm talking about. Now you're thinking I probably could have done this earlier on by doing this, but I didn't know. I didn't know what was out there. I didn't know the right strategy, and the point, hopefully, that I'm making here to you is you figure out the strategy as you go. Don't get in a hurry. Do trial and error. Just figure it out as you go. So there is one example of a way to take a huge search and narrow it down to something more manageable. Thanks a lot. And any questions, as always, contact me in the library, and we'll talk about your individual situation one-on-one, over the phone, through email. You can come into the library, whatever you want to do. Thanks a lot. This is me, Jeff, signing off.